Before starting, I have to make an announcement. I'm reaching 250 subscribers soon, and to celebrate, instead of doing the usual, I want to do a Q&A, so if you friends come up with any questions, please comment them at my Q&A post in my community tab. I would super appreciate it if you guys leave some questions, because you can't make a Q&A video without having any questions to answer, and I think it will make for an interesting 250 subscriber special overall. And that's the announcement. Let's now start with the video. So, I'm the Big Boat here, with yet another video. In this video we'll be testing the Intel HD Graphics 630, which is an integrated GPU found on many Kaby Lake based CPUs. It has 24 unified shaders, it uses system RAM as VRAM as its an iGPU, and it has a burst frequency of 1100 MHz in my case. I'm also using the latest drivers for it as of the making of the video. As for CPU power, we have this Intel Core i7. No bottlenecks here as it's a high quality one. I undervolted it by -100 MV to reduce temperatures. We also have 16 GB of RAM in dual channel mode. Although 4 GB or even 2 GB should also be enough for the game that we'll be playing today. As well as a 256 GB NVMe SSD for the operating system and a 1 TB external hard drive on which the game that we'll be testing today is installed. As for operating system, we're using Revengeance 1022H2. You can find a full description of the specs in the video description down below. The game that we'll be benchmarking today is Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Now, this was originally supposed to be a Metal Gear Solid 2 Substance video according to this guy's request from the Intel seller in N2840Days, shout out to him still. However, that game is really old and buggy, and it refused to launch, even after applying this patch, so instead I'll be benchmarking Metal Gear Rising. Which by the way I actually tested on the seller and back in the days. Oh well, let's get straight to the point now. Thank you.
Thank you. Wait.